How to install Ansible in Windows 10. Today, we are going to talk about the easier way to install and maintain Ansible inside Windows 10 using the Windows Subsystem for Linux. Yes, you heard correctly. I'm Luca Burton, and welcome in today's episode of Ansible Pilot. Today, we are talking about how to install Ansible in Windows 10. Officially, Windows is not a supported operating system for the controller node, even if Red Hat is working really hard to eliminate barriers to native Windows controller. The reason behind is that there are a lot of Unixism deeply baked into most of Ansible that prevent it from working on native Windows. Basically, Windows don't have the fork syscall implementation. Ansible controller worker model as of 2.10 version makes heavy use of a POSIX fork syscall. Some people use the Cygwin POSIX compatibility project, but sometimes it just breaks, so it's not a reliable solution. The best alternative is to use Windows Subsystem for Linux, also known as WSL. Run WSL version 2 if Windows 10 later than build 2004. Ansible works great on VSL and WSL 2. Do you want to know more about WSL 1 and 2? Have a comparison of feature and being up to date on what is going on and what's the best performance improvement, jump into the Microsoft website. You can find a lot of useful information about this wonderful piece of software. Are you ready to have fun? Let's jump in a quick live demo of how to install the latest version of Ansible in Windows using Windows Subsystem for Linux. Welcome to my Windows 10 machine. First of all, let's start the PowerShell. The easy way is to search and then right-click Run as Administrator because we need administrator right to install WSL. All the functions are available on WSL-help. This is possible because I'm running the latest version. As you can see, there are a lot of different options and everything is well documented. You could, for example, choose the distribution Linux or other parameter. Let me verify the version of Windows 10, going to System Information, and as you can see, is higher than 2004, so I can run WSL version 2. This is already the default for my Windows 10 operating system, and let me list the possible operating system. With WSL-list-o for online, I can see that the default is target the Ubuntu, the latest version 20.04 LTS. But now let's rock and roll. WSL-install is going to download all the necessary packages and tool. So as you can see, it's downloading the Windows subsystem for Linux, then the kernel, and after is going to download the Ubuntu. The installation is fully unattended, so we don't need to do anything rather than wait. The time is influenced by the speed of our machine and our network performance. After the download is complete, Windows automatically is going to install the software on the system, and this is the real time on my machine. I didn't cut the video because I think it's nice to see the real performance of this. It's going to wait few minutes to copy the downloaded file to the target directory, set up the execution kernel. You know, the kernel is the most important part because it's communicating with hardware, so it's going to emulate a full workstation inside our computer. After setting up correctly Windows Assistant for Linux, after setting up VSL kernel, is going to download Ubuntu. We choose the default, that is 20.04 LTS. As you can see, there is a progress bar that slowly is increasing. Windows is going to download this content from the official store. So in the future, I'm expecting that more releases will be available. At the moment, we have Ubuntu, Debian, Kali Linux, which is still Debian based, then OpenSUSE, SUSE Linux Enterprise, and three different versions of Ubuntu. I think that 20.05 is the most convenient because it's still up to date and is LTS, so long-term support. Also, you can add some PPA with that are the way of Ubuntu to distribute some software. So if you want some particular software, is available in extra repository. In our case, Ansible is in the main line, so we don't need this. But if you want the latest version, you can still refer to my video about how to install Ansible in Ubuntu. After the downloading process, there is also the verification, you know, verify the checksum of the image and expanding the archive into the file system. This process is going to take a while just to process. In the end, we can see this message that confirms that operation was successful and we could proceed with a reboot. Once the restart is performed, some also Windows updates are going to be correctly installed, and then on the next reboot, you will find the Ubuntu on the start menu. It's going to take some moment to perfectly install. Also, under the hood, Windows is setting up Hyper-V, that is the virtualization engine that allows us to use Windows subsystem for Linux. Now, usual progress bar updating Windows, but we really don't need to do anything. On the next restart, we are expecting that Ubuntu is setting up, and the expectation is to see this message: installing This may take a few minutes. In this moment, Ubuntu image is expanded from the downloaded archive to our hard drive. We need only to set it up, the username and the password that we would like to use during your everyday usage. Here we are, there is a prompt for the Unix username. In my case, I'm typing Luca and I'm going to choose a password. Let me type twice just for confirmation, and here we are. I'm inside Windows subsystem for Linux with my brand new Ubuntu 20.04. Let me switch to root user with sudo su. First operation, definitely apt-get update to update all the metadata of the repository, and we are ready to have fun. Now we have a full Linux operating system that can take the advantage of the Windows workstation, so it's the best of the both worlds. Specifically, we would like to install Ansible, and we are going to do in one moment, just 1 second, that Windows is processing our metadata file. It's the first time, so you need to be patient. And here we are. We have a prompt and we are able to take a look on the distribution. As you can see, we have all the command line that we are used to. So lsb release is the version Ubuntu, and we can type apt-get install ansible as usual for a Linux machine. The version available is 2.9.6, so it's a bit outdated, but is enough for this distribution. If we want the latest, we need to add one PPA, but this is the usual Ubuntu stuff. Just few minutes and we are able to execute our Ansible command line. As you can see, apt, which is the Ubuntu package manager, is taking care of all the dependency of the library, especially on the Python. You know, Ansible relies a lot on Python, and WinRAM is the library to communicate with Windows host. Now is like few seconds more and we are able to use Ansible from the command line. As you can see, there is not a lot of interaction, is more or less waiting time, because we spend only few commands for installing the Windows subsystem for Linux, and also for updating the Ubuntu distribution and to install Ansible on it. So I think that Microsoft did a very well job to integrate the open source in Windows. This is the final operation, update the documentation page, the man in Ubuntu slang. And we are nearly to the completion. Now we are back to the prompt, and we can verify that Ansible is successfully installed. As you can see, the Ansible --- version return 2.9.6. That was exactly what we were expecting. So, good job. Here we are. Let's have fun. Now you know how to install the latest version of Ansible in Windows 10 using the Windows subsystem for Linux version 2. Thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, give us a thumb up. And see you soon on next lesson. This video is part of our Ansible automation program. Sign up today on www.ansiblepilot.com for uninterrupted exclusive video and so much fun.